From NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, you're watching live coverage of the 14th SpaceX cargo resupply mission to the International Space Station. Hi, I'm Tori McClendon. Thanks for joining us. Today's launch to the station is scheduled for 4:30 p.m. Eastern Time from Space Launch Complex 40 on Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. Coming up, we'll hear from SpaceX directly from their Mission Control Center and also learn about some of the groundbreaking research headed to the space station. Today's launch will be the first of the year for NASA from Pad 40. The Dragon spacecraft and Falcon 9 rocket will deliver about 5,800 pounds of research, crew supplies, and hardware to the orbiting laboratory. The Dragon spacecraft launching today was previously flown on SpaceX's 8th cargo resupply mission for NASA to the station. The launch window today is instantaneous, meaning SpaceX has a single second to launch. About 10 minutes after the launch, the Dragon will reach its preliminary orbit. It will then deploy its solar arrays and begin a series of thruster firings as it heads to the station. The spacecraft is scheduled to arrive on Wednesday, April 4th. We are now about half an hour away from the launch. Let's check in with NASA's Josh Finch and Kennedy's Launch Control Center for some updates on the Falcon 9 rocket and an update on the weather. Josh?
Thank you, Tori, and welcome to those who are joining us for a live coverage of SpaceX CRS-14's flight to the International Space Station. I'm located on Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, not far away from the launch site at Space Launch Complex 40, where the Falcon 9 will lift off. The Falcon 9 is a two-staged rocket standing at about 230 feet tall. The rocket's first stage is powered by 9 Merlin engines and fueled by liquid oxygen and rocket-grade kerosene, also called RP-1. After engine ignition, a hold before release system ensures that all engines are verified for full thrust performance before the rocket is released for flight. Then, with a thrust greater than 5 747s at full power, the Merlin engines launch the rocket to space. The first and the second stages are connected by what's called the interstage. Falcon 9's second stage is powered by a single Merlin vacuum engine, nearly identical to the first stage engines, but modified to operate in the vacuum of space. It delivers Falcon 9's payload to the desired orbit. The second stage engine ignites for a few seconds after stage separation. At the top of the rocket is Dragon, which carries cargo in the spacecraft's pressurized capsule and in the unpressurized trunk. The Dragon spacecraft and trunk is just over 26 feet high and 12 feet in diameter. Dragon will connect to the space station's Harmony module. In May, the spacecraft will splash down in the Pacific Ocean off the coast of Baja, California, returning science experiments to Earth. Today, the launch countdown has proceeded per the timeline. Milestones already performed include collision avoidance with the Eastern Range, a checkout of the autonomous flight termination system, loading of RP-1 fuel began at T-minus 1 hour, 11 minutes, and the loading of liquid oxygen began at T-minus 35 minutes at 3:55 p.m. Launch teams received a weather briefing from the U.S. Air Force 45th Space Wing, who are providing insight into a whole host of weather-related details such as wind speed, cloud coverage, potential for thunderstorms and lightning in the surrounding area, and even solar weather, which launch teams need to know before committing to launch. The countdown is proceeding, and U.S. Air Force 45th Weather Squadron Officer Mike McAleenan has noted some anvil clouds that got about as close as 8 nautical miles to the launch site. However, that's produced no lightning at this time, so we remain go for weather, but we'll keep an eye on that as it develops throughout the launch countdown. But with that, we are still go for launch, with winds at about 10 to 15 miles per hour out of the east-southeast. Temperature is about 80 degrees. We're about 80% go for launch, which keeping us that extra 20% is flight through precipitation and the cumulus cloud rule. And with that, we'll go back to Tori McClendon. Tori?